added, it will because of their terrific quarterback, Rakeem Cato. The last 2 years, he has just put up spectacular numbers.
And 5 wins last year. They could go to 10 this year, and a lot of it's because Cato's actually checking to the run more often. His number's down after a year where he had to throw it a ton, but he is a defensive coordinator's worst nightmare. When he goes off script, the way Marshall has set up their offense, there are a lot of vertical routes. You beat the left tackle, you've got a sack. Well, no, Cato's athletic enough to come out of that to his left, but watch what he does. He sets up and launches the ball. Marshall, when you study them on tape, throw the ball deep as much or more than anybody in the country. And the bad news for a defensive coordinator, that's Gator Hoskins. He's a tight end. He can run like a wide receiver.
Another storyline, these coaches have a real history with each other. Doc Holliday was a linebacker at West Virginia. Randy Edsall, a quarterback at Syracuse, when they played each other every year. Then as assistant coaches at those schools, they recruited head-to-head very successfully, by the way, in the same South Florida area where schools from the Northeast always go for speed. They've built great respect for each other, and now they face off as head coaches for the first time. Moments away from kickoff, but first, here's Janine Edwards.
Well, Mike, if there's one thing the Maryland coaches have gotten very good at this year, it's game planning with new starters just about every week. I mean, you heard them talking about all the guys they've lost. 17 starters have gone down with injuries. Head coach Randy Edsall said he's had to become very creative and think outside the box. And he's told his players, hey, don't worry about who's out there or who's not out there. Worry about stepping up when we need you. And one guy who has, freshman cornerback Will Likely. The coaches say they've had to throw him to the wolves, but he continues to flourish. And watch for him on punt and kickoff returns also. He's become their not-so-secret weapon. Mike?
Janine, thanks very much. Often we look at bowl games as to who wants to be here more. I have to look at this game and say both of them do.
And for Maryland, it's really 2 years of injuries. You go back to last year, this was a Maryland team that was down to their fifth string quarterback.
Who was a linebacker.
Who was a linebacker, yes. Who'll be playing today on defense for Randy Edsall. A masterful job. After Ralph Regan left, things went to 2-10. They crept back with 4 wins last year. They could double their win total this year with all the injuries. It's been a masterful job by Edsall.
Maryland won the toss, deferred to the second half. So Marshall will receive.
And for Marshall, you talk about teams that want to be here. Here's a team that lost to Rice in the Conference USA Championship. Not very happy with how they played. So this is an opportunity for Marshall to get back on the national stage with a big audience and play like they're capable. Here's a team under Doc Holliday. They had 5 wins last year. They could double that total with a win today to 10. Just staggering.
And except for that conference championship game, they had a shot at winning every other game they played. So it's been a remarkable year for them, and we're not exactly sure.
Well, there was
both teams out there what the holdup is right now.
I believe there was a photo opportunity in the middle of the field that they were finishing up.
It's a perfect day, by the way. I mean, it's in the 30s, close to 40. It's supposed to go up to around 42, 43 degrees later this afternoon. But a bright sunshine and very little wind. Watson and Reeves are deep for Marshall. And Brad Craddock will kick it away. He's had 12 touchbacks this year in 64 kickoffs. And we are underway in Annapolis. Taken at the goal line by Reeves. Has a hole up the middle and burst through across the 30-yard line to the 31. William Likely made what looked like a saving tackle. Rakeem Cato of Marshall rewriting the record book, and that record book includes two pretty good guys, Chad Pennington and Byron Leftwich. He's got a chance to eclipse some of their records today, and he has put up spectacular numbers in his sophomore and junior seasons. They'll start with 5 wide receivers and Cato alone in the backfield. Watch Shuler number 1 and Hoskins number 26.
Cato tries to take off, and he's sacked on the opening play of the game, taken down at the 29-yard line. Andre Monroe and Quentin Jefferson poured through that Marshall front wall.
Jefferson, a sophomore, coming on strong for this defense, coached by Brian Stewart, the defensive coordinator for Randy Edsall. Really impressive defensive coach. They've had their handful of issues with guys being injured. They've lost pass rushers, cornerbacks. They've been hurt by it as well.
Cato with time, and that is Shuler, and that is catch number 98 on the year. He's over 1,100 yards. Isaac Goines had a man-to-man and couldn't stop him, although he was close. Marshall loves the up-tempo. Cato, pump fake. Marshall lineman is down and hurt, and Cato throws for Hoskins, incomplete. It's the right tackle, Clint Van Horn, second team all-conference. He went down in the middle of the play.
And here is where Cato is so dangerous. Brian Stewart, the defense coordinator for Maryland, as they tend to Van Horn, looks like his right arm. They want him to bail. They want to push him to his left. A mistake there was made by Marcus Whitfield, the outside linebacker, and looked like a potential arm injury to Van Horn. But that's a missed throw by Cato. He had Hoskins open and just underthrew that ball. Hoskins was wide open down the field, just like we showed you at the open, and Cato just missed it.
Tyler Williams, who averages 42 and a half yards a kick, to punt to Likely. Likely waits at the 20. Maryland showing a 10-man front. They back out of the pressure. And a high floating kick, Lake Fair catch signal made, and the catch made at the 21. 39-yard punt and no return. C.J. Brown will come back next year for his sixth season as a Maryland quarterback. He has an injury-riddled career that has cost him 2 years. It's nice to see that the NCAA has gone with that rule in the last few years and allowed kids who, through no fault of their own, did not have a chance to play 4 seasons in 5 years.
And with that ACL injury, everyone who's ever had one, like Brown had last year, say the second year, you're much healthier than the first. So it's good news for Terrapins.
Brandon Ross gets the first carry, takes it up to the 27-yard line. Ross, one of three tailbacks that we will see for Maryland in this game. You'll also see Albert Reed and Jaquiel Vey. The Terps also going up-tempo almost all year except the Clemson game when they lost so many players and wanted to shorten it. They need to get to the 31-yard line for a first down. McKelvey makes the tackle, and we will check the penalty marker.
Personal foul, chop block, offense, number 66. Half the distance to goal, second down.
That's Andrew Zeller, huge penalty against the Terps.
Yeah, right guard number 66, Zeller. This is, he engages low as the right tackle, Michael Dunn, comes high. So that was a rule put in several years ago. When a player is engaged low, a player cannot engage high. Not quite sure. If you're working a combination, that's a mental error by one or the other guy.
Right.
You either say, we're staying up, or I'm going to cut, and you go up to the linebacker. So that's a mental error by the Maryland offensive line.
Pushes him all the way back to the 13-yard line, so Brown goes to the pistol. Fakes to Ross, under pressure, and Brown sacked back at the 5. James Rouse, the defensive tackle, who is also coming back next year for his sixth year, and a young man who had so many injuries here, he nearly gave up the game of college football, but inspired to stay, he has been terrific.
Oh, I apologize. Rouse actually moved down to the inside. I circled the defensive end of that side, but Rouse has become a permanent captain, came back from all those injuries, and now Maryland, boy, I'd be really, with all this momentum going towards Marshall, I think something like a quarterback draw here. I wouldn't be throwing this.
They're going to go with something safe. They get it out to Ross in the flat, but he's covered up well. Goes down at the 14-yard line. So the penalty really affected that drive as Jermaine Holmes finishes the play. And Maryland will have to kick it away.
And you notice the big number 75 on the side of the Marshall players' helmets. That is in honor of the 75 players and or people who died on the plane crash that killed 36 members of the football team and staff of Marshall football back in 1970. So military honor on one side and honoring the victims of that horrific plane crash on the other.
Devon Smith, one of the two deep men. He averages 15 and a half yards a return. They love to get him to football. Smith. That's why across midfield, still on his feet, fighting for extra yardage inside the Maryland 45. A dynamic 16-yard return by Devon Smith. We're at the Military Bowl in Annapolis and back after this.
At Northrop Grumman, we've always been on the forefront of innovation. When the world called for speed, when the world called for stealth, intelligence, endurance, affordability, adaptability. And when the world asked for the future, staying ahead in a constantly evolving world, that's the value of performance. Northrop Grumman.
And so you can see, you're like right here, I can just, you know, check my policy here, add a car, speak to customer service, check on a claim, you know, all with the tap of my Geico app.
Oh, that's so cool.
Well, I would disagree with you, but that would make me a liar.
No, dude, you're on the Jumbotron.
Oh. Yeah, I pretty much walked into that one.
Geico, anywhere, anytime. Just a tap away on the Geico app.
Saturday, Stephen Morris quarterbacks the Canes against Teddy Bridgewater and the Cardinals in the Russell Athletic Bowl. Capital One Bowl Week continues. Miami battles Louisville Saturday at 6:45 on ESPN. College football lives here.
Start with a new Surface, complete with Office, then add a keyboard. Try the two-in-one that's both a laptop and a tablet. Or the lightweight all-in-one you can even take with you. There's the phone with 41 megapixels and reinvented zoom. And the 8-inch Windows tablet with up to 14 hours of battery life. All of these amazing devices come with the same incredible experience. That's the new Windows. One experience on every device for everything in your life.
Offensively, we're going to turn it loose. Where's Cato? Yes, you got the ball in your hands. You got it? Yes, go do something. Offense. Where's Billy? Billy's not. We're not holding him back. You got it? Defensively, we're getting after it. Do you understand that? We're going to throw everything at him. We're going to leave nothing on that football field. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Let's be a great football team today, and let's go out there and show the country on a national stage what kind of football team Marshall University has. You got that?
Yes, sir.
On three, showtime. Here we go. One, two, three, showtime. Go! Yeah!
Doc Holliday, who has built a reputation as an outstanding assistant coach at several places and a great recruiter, gets a chance to be a head coach at Marshall. He has taken it and run with it. They've got a shot at their 10th victory of the season today. And they'll go with Taliaferro on the running play. This is a team that didn't run much at all last year. Now they're 22nd in the country rushing, 21st in the country passing. You want balance? You got balance.
Doc Holliday, the offensive line improvement, but Clint Van Horn, we got the report from Janine down on the field, out, their right tackle taken to the locker room to look at that arm.
Cato throws complete to the 41. Got it to Craig Wilkins. Going to be third down at about 6 yards.
Well, and this is where, if you're Maryland, you better know where number 26, Gator Hoskins, is. He's lined up to the left. He's a mismatch. He's in the slot to the left, working on number 20, Anthony Nixon, right here. And also Shuler, I believe, is to that side. I'm looking left here.
Cato throws intended for Devon Smith and overthrows.
Well, I saw that one from Smith, but
yeah,
it was 11.
The same side.
Yeah, I thought it was Shuler on that side, but that looked like a missed route that time. Shuler was lined up to the right. Hoskins was running a short intermediate route, and Devon Smith looked like he ran the wrong route. It looked like Cato was expecting him to run a takeoff route, and Devon Smith cut that route off too early, it looked like to me.
And Devon Smith, if he ran the wrong route, is going to be upset. He grew up wanting to play for Maryland. Marshall going to make the conservative play, supposedly here with a punt from the 41-yard line. High floater. Really well covered by the Thundering Herd. And they'll down it inside the 1 yard line. Outstanding job. DeAndre Reeves, one of three players who said, if it's going to bounce this way, we're going to wait as long as we can. And they down it at the half yard line.
Character. For America's veterans, it was important then. It's important now. In uniform, you were responsible for everyone around you. Then you came home to be responsible homeowners, parents, and citizens. You pay your mortgage on time, take pride in your home, and know that providing for your family is what really matters. Here in my hometown, there's a lender who feels the same way. New Day USA. They understand veterans' needs. They offer home loans that are VA guaranteed, loans that let you refinance your mortgages, consolidate credit card debt, and lower your monthly payment, and even get you the money you need to meet other responsibilities, like your children's education. Character. It's always been important to me, and it's always been important to New Day USA.
Refinance and get the money you need in as little as 30 days from New Day USA. Call now, 1-877-776-2540.
The Chrysler Big Finish event is here. And with it comes the inevitable hustle and bustle of the season. But when you stop to reflect on what you have and everything it took to get it, you realize that the greatest gift is what you give back. Hurry in. Some of the best deals of the year at the Chrysler Big Finish event end January 2nd. Get 0% financing for up to 72 months, plus $500 bonus cash on most Chrysler vehicles.
Mine was earned orbiting the moon in 1971.
Afghanistan in 2009.
On the USS Saratoga in 1982.
Once it's earned, USAA auto insurance is often handed down from generation to generation because it offers a superior level of protection and because USAA's commitment to serve current and former military members and their families is without equal. Begin your legacy. Get an auto insurance quote. USAA. We know what it means to serve.
The 2013 Military Bowl is presented by Northrop Grumman. Northrop Grumman, the value of performance. And in part by New Day USA, America's mortgage company. And Chrysler, imported from Detroit.
Before our game, the Military Bowl hosted a parade that included the famous Budweiser Clydesdales, bands, cheerleaders, as well as several recipients of the Medal of Honor, the nation's highest military award given for personal acts of valor above and beyond the call of duty. And we salute all of you. Maryland takes over in the shadow of its own goalpost, and Brown wedges it out to near the three.
Well, let's see if that punt worked out for Doc Holliday. Decided on that 4th and 7. I think if Holliday gets it to 4th and 2 or 3, they probably go for it there. But they got the great punt down to the 1. So you mentioned the conservative choice. Let's see if it pays off here and they get the ball back with good field position.
Maryland trapped themselves deep in their own territory in the opening possession with a personal foul. The Terps looking for a little operating room. Albert Reed, the tailback, in the eye. And Reed will get the carry. Nowhere to go. Fortunate to get back to the line of scrimmage as that Marshall forward wall stood strong.
And number 11, James Rouse, has just been in the backfield the entire game. He doesn't make the tackle there, but lined up over the right guard, Andrew Zeller. Rouse got great push, an undersized guy playing inside. He was a defensive end He missed over 700 days of action with injuries. Came back this year. They moved him to a new position, and he's playing really well early in this game.
Third and long. Maryland just looking for some operating room. A little pushing and shoving after the play.
And Maryland lucky not to get a safety there. This
absolutely.
Was, yeah, this was something Mike Locksley, the offensive coordinator, told us he was concerned about, is the quick defensive line of Marshall and how they move and slant and they run some stunts. That time looked to me like Brandon Sparrow was running free.
We asked Chuck Keeter, the first-year defensive coordinator, why the defense was so much better under his tutelage in his first year. He says that I had a lot better players this year than they did last year.
14, as many as 14 new faces played for Marshall on defense this year. 9 of them finished with 27 or more tackles, a huge improvement defensively in personnel.
Renfro. Smith runs up on it, always trying to make something happen, but he won't this time. Thrown back after he reached the Maryland 37-yard line by A.J. Hendy. A 1-yard return after a punt of 34. So Marshall dominating field position early, and we'll see if they can take advantage of it with this much more balanced offense of 2013.
One of the things that Rakeem Cato, when the coaches talked about him early in his career, was kind of calming him down a little bit. He's a very competitive guy. Early on, he's missed a couple of throws. There looked like one that might have been a mental error on the route, but he missed Gator Hoskins on the third down before, and they missed the throw on the other third down. So let's see if Cato got to the sideline and got settled down a bit.
He's got Taliaferro in the backfield with him, fakes it to him. Good protection this time, throws sideline, contact before the ball got there. That should be a penalty, and it will be. Schuler was covered by Likely, and Likely got there a step too soon.
Awfully close. If Likely jumps to play this ball instead of running through the man, in my eye, this was the right call. But Likely clearly goes to play the receiver instead of the ball.
Pass interference. Defense. Number 4. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Likely, the man that young man that Janine mentioned, had to step up with Dexter McDougal out for the season. Jeremiah Johnson's just coming back, but clearly not making a. You don't have to make a play on the ball, but if he jumps to try to play this and there's that contact, I don't know that they call it, but because he runs and is hitting the receiver, Schuler, before the ball got there, I think that's the correct call.
Dan Romeo is the referee of our Mountain West crew for this ball game. High snap. They get it to Taliaferro inside the 20. Taken down by L.A. Gorey and Quentin Jefferson.
One of the things that Rakeem Cato does, and it's not every quarterback can do this, he has a choice on every single play, either a run or a pass or two passes in one. And they said the one thing he's done this year with the offense is he understands it. Last year he knew it, now he understands it. Makes a lot of run checks.
Taliaferro dives inside the 15-yard line. Michael Selby, the left guard, Conference USA All-Freshman team, was leading the way.
And last year it really was all pretty much, they averaged 169 rushing, not terrible, but it was really through the arm and receiving of Schuler and Hoskins. But now, because of the understanding of Cato and counting and understanding where the run fits are better on the offense, calling a lot more runs.
Straight up the middle to the goal line, Taliaferro, touchdown. His 10th rushing touchdown of the season. And he's doing it in front of the home folks. He was a local product out of Damatha.
Well,
looked like his knee was down.
Now, the problem is that angle is on the player's side. The camera's on the player's side of the end line. I think this might be the better angle to see. Again.
The call on the field is a touchdown, so that will prevail if they don't find convincing evidence to overturn it. Pretty tough to find convincing evidence there.
Yeah, I think you could dispute. The term is indisputable
video
evidence.
The field was a touchdown. The previous play is now under further review.
And that, again, because the camera's upfield, there's no way to tell. That's just too close to call.
And remember, just the point of the football has to cross the front part of the white line.
That's all. That's a touchdown.
That angle right there, if you made me choose touchdown, not touchdown, I'm saying that's not a touchdown. However, the rule says indisputable video evidence. A reasonable person could dispute that and say, wait a minute, by that definition, meaning the point, the first point of the ball breaks the pane of glass. But if they do reverse it, it's still first and goal on the 1-inch line.
Well, you know, I'm not a reasonable person, but I will dispute that.
I'm with you.
I think it was too close to reverse.
I agree. But if they do reverse, remember, it's still first and goal from the inch line for Marshall. And what a nice call by Cato, the quarterback. How open was the middle of the field when he checked to that run?
After further review, the runner's knee was down prior to the ball breaking the plane. Ball will be placed at the half-yard line. First and goal, Marshall.
I'm with you, Mike. I think you let that one stand. It was within an inch or two either way, but I just didn't see indisputable video evidence. That was a touchdown.
We've had several of these calls this year where you can't complain. I mean, you can't really get upset if they go
either one way or the other. Yeah. And again, the point here is Marshall still gets the ball first and goal inside the one. So get three or four plays to try to score.
Will they give Taliaferro another shot at it? They will. And he didn't get there. He was stuffed by Andre Monroe. He may have lost a half a yard.
Well, Andre Monroe, a 5'11", 270-pound nose guard, has been playing really well. Got another guy from Maryland who missed last year, gets under the pads. Now you know Maryland's going to move their front. They're going to do things to not let you run in the middle. Try to get Cato on the edge with a run-pass option. I'm not sure you want to try to run between the tackles again.
Cato looks, throws, completes to Tommy Shuler. Touchdown, Marshall. 99 catches, 10 touchdowns for Shuler. There is another flag down, however.
Offside. Defense, number 41, lined up in the neutral zone. The penalty is declined. Touchdown.
Shuler or Hoskins are the last two guys on the field that should be that open.
Well, they had two receivers to that shot side. Both receivers worked together. Defensive backs crossed up, and Shuler was standing wide open. Shuler and Cato with such a great relationship. But going back to school kids, they were out throwing the football around together down in South Florida.
You know, the pick play has become an art form with wide receivers. And it's 7-0. The Thundering Herd of Marshall with the lead, and Rakeem Cato, his 37th touchdown pass of the year. The school record's 39.
The Chrysler Big Finish event is here, and with it comes the inevitable hustle and bustle of the season. But when you stop to reflect on what you have and everything it took to get it, you realize that the greatest gift is what you give back. Hurry in. Some of the best deals of the year at the Chrysler Big Finish event end January 2nd. Get 0% financing for up to 72 months, plus $500 bonus cash on most Chrysler vehicles.
Your mama's got nothing on me. Your daddy's got nothing.
Why would you ever need to eat nachos on the go? Let's say her parents came home early. That's one reason.
The new grilled stuffed nacho for $1.29 at Taco Bell. Everything you love about nachos grilled up in an all new way. Take the nachos and run.
Does not take away from the greatness of Silva.
And now they meet again.
Ronda Rousey really believes she has some unfinished business with Misha Tate.
Here we go once again.
Tis the season for NBA League Pass with this limited time holiday offer. You'll get live NBA games on your TV, computer, tablet, and phone. Alley-oop! Watch the incredible action anywhere. Buy NBA League Pass for only four payments of $42.99. To order now, call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or visit directtv.com/NBA.
Chad Pennington, Byron Leftwich, Rakeem Cato, the top three quarterbacks that have ever played for Marshall. And Cato has just tied Leftwich for number two all-time in career touchdown passes. Not going to catch Chad Pennington, at least not this year, but...
but if he's healthy next year...
He'll catch
it. With Shuler. We went back and looked at that route. It actually wasn't a pick route. It was just Shuler working one-on-one, but the relationship...
There's Byron.
Yeah.
Had a good NFL career. Had a great career at Marshall.
But I think the guy on the right is going to pass both he and Pennington next year. And I think Cato's a guy with some of these huge numbers. If Marshall can get into the conversation late, undefeated, he might be a guy that starts getting talked for Heisman because the numbers would be so crazy.
Curry puts it out of the end zone. Maryland will have to go from the 25. Our chance to check in with Janine.
Well, guys, Marshall coach Doc Holliday said that Rakeem Cato is one of the most competitive guys he has ever been around, and he's worked with quarterbacks like Phillip Rivers and Tim Tebow and Andrew Luck. He said football means more to this guy than anything. He lost his mom at the age of 12. He came from a tough environment. Football was his way out. And I can tell you from watching him on the sideline, there is no one screaming louder or jacking his players up more than Rakeem Cato.
He has had a wonderful year. He's turned into a leader for this program, and that's what you need out of your quarterback. Brown's going to run the option. The pitch to Ross. And Ross forced out of bounds just shy of the 30-yard line.
Ross, one of those guys who was banged up this year. We mentioned that Clemson game we did. Ross was out with a shoulder injury. Dave Steinbaugh, the tight end, was out. They lost Stephon Diggs and Deion Long, their two best receivers by far, the week before against Wake Forest, so nice to have Ross back.
Keep by Brown. Up to about the 34. Now, we're not necessarily talking about a play like that on a run, but they encourage him when it's a passing play not to sit in the pocket. If his first read isn't there, think about taking off, especially against man-to-man defenses when people have their backs turned.
And it's not always to run either, just to buy time, get out of the pocket. Here on third and short, I don't know how this isn't something through the hands of Brown, a zone read type of play. They're lined up in a power run, but I would think Brown on the edge is a good option here. Remember the penetration Marshall's been getting up front.
Goins is the fullback. Ross will get the carry. First down and more. To the 45-yard line. Good block by the fullback Goins.
This is called an ISO lead, where the fullback Goins is isolated, working one-on-one with the linebacker. That's number 31, Evan McKelvey, who comes up. A terrific block by the fullback. But that's the one-on-one. You're trying to set that up. That's just straight power run. If my fullback can beat that free linebacker, we pick up the first down.
Being a fullback's a lot of fun if you don't mind being a battering ram. Ross trying to get to the outside, slipped one tackle. We'll pick up about 4 yards. Taken down by Darrell Roberts.
You talk about the depth issues that Randy Edsall has had to deal with in the last two seasons.
Unbelievable.
We mentioned they went through four quarterbacks last year, ended up converting a redshirt freshman linebacker who played some option quarterback. And they were the talk of the coaching community. There were a lot of people we'd visit with saying, what's going on at Maryland? How do they even have an offense at the end of the year?
And they gave Clemson all it could handle. Brown in trouble. Throws as he goes down and completes it to Edetawa. Heck of a job by C.J. Brown on the way to the ground as Corey Tindall had him wrapped up. He found Edetawa for 16 yards.
This is big. You get these extra 15 practices. Edetawa, a guy who wasn't playing as much when Diggs and Long were healthy. A little bit dangerous there going down throwing that. But Edetawa had found a hole there in the middle. And this young freshman, Edetawa, is starting to become a big player with Diggs and Long out.
A single back is Ross. Brown gives it to Jacobs on the fly sweep. And Jacobs out of bounds at the 30. When we did that Clemson game and Maryland was missing all those offensive players, they were also missing both of their starting corners and a couple of linebackers. I mean, I was wondering before the game if it wasn't going to be 89-0.
And here's a team that dismissed maybe their best running back before the season for breaking team rules in Les Brown. So it's really amazing what they've done with their personnels, the personnel groupings in and out.
Fake to Ross. Brown hit as he throws, got it to Jacobs. Laverne Jacobs, touchdown. Boy, nice series for C.J. Brown. Saved one play as he was falling and then hung in under pressure and threw a strike to Laverne Jacobs, who has become his favorite receiver after the loss of Diggs and Long.
Brown knew he was going to get hit and still transferred his weight. That ball had plenty of zip on the way to Jacobs. Nice throw.
Craddock for the point after.
One of the things we've talked to Mike Locksley, the offensive coordinator and quarterback coach, said C.J. Brown's a good runner. He has a good arm. He's really worked on his mechanics. He knew he was going to get popped right in the mouth by Darrell Roberts, but he still delivered a strike. C.J. Brown's starting to grow and has another year to go.
Becoming an effective leader begins with a great education.
Building strong management skills, learning to solve problems,
and understanding how to make a difference began for me at Marshall University.
When I was deciding which university to attend,
there were many choices.
Knowing the reputation of Marshall, its strong history, roots in the community, and success of its alumni.
It was by far the best.
The best.
The best.
Decision.
Decision.
The best decision ever.
Jacobs with the touchdown catch, and his effort along with C.J. Brown have tied the military bowl at 7 between Marshall and Maryland.
Well, as Maryland gets ready to leave the ACC for the Big Ten, everybody wondering how they're going to be able to compete. Of course, they got the tough draw in the East: Michigan, Michigan State, Ohio State, Penn State.
Anybody else?
Thank you very much. But you see what Randy Edsall has done and what they're going to bring back next year, including C.J. Brown, and they get those receivers, Diggs, back. They also get another receiver back in Marcus Leak, who has tremendous speed. I think they're going to compete very well.
Well, look
right out of the gate.
UConn. He started from absolutely nothing, working out of a trailer. Short kick taken by Reeves. Room to run up the middle again, and Reeves crosses to 30. Tonight, Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN with two more bowl games after the conclusion of our contest. It's the Texas Bowl, Syracuse and Minnesota. And at 9:30, the Fight Hunger Bowl, BYU and Washington. Capital One Bowl Week continues tonight on ESPN, as well as live on Watch ESPN. And if Minnesota wasn't one of the great stories of the year, I don't know what could be.
Jerry Kill, unfortunately, suffers from epilepsy and had to step down as the head coach. Tracy Clays, the defensive coordinator, took over, and they went on a run. We saw them early. They looked a little shaky. Boy, did they improve as the season went on.
Cato in the gun. And hands it off to Remy Watson, getting a chance to play the tailback spot. Only 24 carries all year for Watson, but obviously one thing he brings to the position is speed.
There's Cato again. Every play he's checking read or pass. He's seeing the numbers in the run game.
Sets and throws strong, complete. Wilkins makes his second grab before he's finally driven back. Picks up 8 or 9 yards. Here's Janine.
Well, guys, the Maryland offense have stepped up. Now it's time for the defense. And defensive coordinator Brian Stewart has not been happy with confusion that he's seeing and a lack of communication. He said, guys, you have got to echo the call, every single player. Don't come off the field and tell me you didn't know what the call was. And he wants them to do a better job executing their pressure.
Cato changing the play, and they're trying to do it, Janine, with 4 down linemen. This time they bring 5. They don't get there, and Cato with a beautiful touch pass to Frohnapple. We've seen him set and gun it. That time he just floated it perfectly into Eric Frohnapple's hands.
He is a very varied thrower. He can throw it on a line. He lofts it this time. Frohnapple. It was all pressure. They had one-on-one, waited for a second, had Frohnapple over the middle. That's a nice, easy throw. Plus, you know your tight end's running away from the defender. If you can lead him a bit, that could be six. Nice throw, though, by Cato on that throw.
That's the danger of the blitz. If you don't get there, it creates problems. They blitz again. The pass goes underneath to Devin Johnson, and the third-string tight end takes it to the 15-yard line, close to another first down.
You know a coaching staff's doing a good job recruiting when they have a guy like Gator Hoskins, who's an NFL tight end, and Devin Johnson has come on and looks like he's just going to take the reins at tight end. And we already saw Frohnapple. You go three deep at the tight end position. That's hard to defend for anybody, but Maryland especially right now struggling in their man-to-man.
Second down and inches, and now a first down inside the five is Remy Watson. Barrels down deep into Maryland territory.
Maryland looks like a defense confused right now, and it looks like Brian Stewart's trying to simplify, trying to go to some man coverage, but right now everything looks easy for Marshall.
In their hurry up, Cato throws a slant, and a flag is going to come down on this one unlikely. He was covering Justin Hurt. Looked like the ball was thrown late, and that looked like pretty good coverage.
Now, officials are taught that if it's what is termed a bang-bang play, meaning the defender and the ball get there at about the same time, you're not supposed to call pass interference. This is something that they actually give the defense the benefit of the doubt because you can't guess.
Pass interference. Defense, number four. Penalty occurred in the end zone. We'll place the ball at the 2-yard line, first and goal.
Let's check real time, top of your screen. And watch if it's a bang-bang ball player. I don't know how you call that. And it's the back judge calling it, not the side judge, so he cannot see that right hand. I think that's a missed call.
That is pretty darn good coverage. And again, trying to run in a first and goal situation, Remy Watson wrapped up.
And likely, remember, was the guy who was called for the pass interference on the touchdown drive before.
Yes.
That one I agreed with. The one that we just saw, I think you have to let number four make that play.
Second and goal. Watson has been the tailback this entire series. Whistles will stop the play.
Good break for Maryland defense. Get a free 5 yards.
Offense, number 60, 5-yard penalty. Second out.
It's a veteran center, Chris Jaspers, the former walk-on.
And that's a big penalty. You go to second and eight. Second and goal from the eight. You pick up no yardage. You're at third and goal from the eight. That's a tough down and distance. The way the ball is spread, Maryland's tempting a run here.
Cato, touchdown. Hoskins wide open in the back of the end zone. He has shown us everything in his repertoire, and he is on fire.
Came out a little shaky, but that right there, that was a complete read by the quarterback. Did you see those linebackers starting to come up to play the run? He puts it right over their head to Hoskins.
An impressive dot drive by Rakeem Cato. Showed your arm strength, the ability to read a defense, and great touch. Can't ask much more. Laid it into Hoskins for the touchdown. 14-7, the Thundering Herd.
It starts here, the birth of an idea, the heart of innovation and entrepreneurship. Informed by a $500 million research enterprise, shaped by our global perspective, encouraged, prodded, tested, improved, until it becomes fearless. Because we believe fearless ideas ignite bold invention, spark quantum advances, and drive passionate leaders. From research to development to launch, we are dedicated to the power of fearless ideas. We are the University of Maryland.
Visit WatchESPN.com or download the WatchESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
It's been an exciting first quarter here in the Military Bowl. Marshall has taken a 14-7 lead.
And this one barely catches the corner of the end zone for another touchback. And Maryland will start at the 25-yard line.
Well, C.J. Brown, who is going to get a second senior year. And this offense just really struggled when Caleb Rowe, who has a really good arm, came in, the backup quarterback, had a nice game against Virginia, struggled a bit against Wake Forest in that loss, but played pretty well against Clemson. But the offense changed quite a bit. Rowe was more of a thrower and Brown more a true dual threat guy. So that's what they're better at and with Brown in the backfield. So this offense got much better down the stretch.
Ross is the tailback. They moved the ball well in the last series against the Terps, or against the Thundering Herd. And Ross will pick up five here. Corey Tindall made the stop. The nickelback, who was the co-freshman of the year with Tulane's Nico Marley, and we saw him a week ago. He's a heck of a player.
You share an honor with Nico Marley.
Pretty good.
Yeah, looks like he makes every tackle for Tulane, 180-pound linebacker. But Tindall, a guy who Chuck Heater, the defensive coordinator, who's been some big places, Florida, Washington, said he could have played anywhere for him.
Read option, Brown on the keep. He's out to the 35. And that'll do it for the first quarter. Marshall with the advantage over the Terrapins of Maryland, 14-7 from here in Annapolis.
I love telling big stories about big heroes, but at the end of the day, real life is better than any story. Our servicemen and women are the real heroes. Every day, they make the sacrifices for their country, for my country, for my son's country. The USO gives us real ways to support our real heroes. There is a way we can say thanks. You can go to USO.org and make a real difference in their lives today. Do it.
Job is to make athletes better, to help Jordan Spieth compete for championships, turn Willie's family business into a dynasty, and to make Lindsey Vonn faster than ever before. Under Armour will push the bobsled harder, make Shawnee Davis feel supersonic, and get Bobby Brown higher than the rest. Under Armour can make tight feel nice, make strong look pretty, and help make Lindsey's comeback a reality. But most of all, Under Armour empowers the next athlete to believe that they can do anything.
And now my journey across the country has brought me to the lovely city of Boston. Cheers. And seeing as it's such a historic city, I'm sure they'll appreciate that GEICO has been saving people money for over 75 years. Oh dear. I've dropped my tea into the Boston Harbor. I guess this party's over.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
The Chrysler Big Finish event is here. And with it comes the inevitable hustle and bustle of the season. But when you stop to reflect on what you have and everything it took to get it, you realize that the greatest gift is what you give back. Hurry in. Some of the best deals of the year at the Chrysler Big Finish event end January 2nd. Get 0% financing for up to 72 months, plus $500 bonus cash on most Chrysler vehicles.
Here's a question for you. Where does the United States get most of its energy? Is it Africa, the Middle East, Canada, or the U.S.? The answer is the U.S. Most of America's energy comes from right here at home. Take the energy quiz. Energy lives here.
70 teams will play in bowl games, leading many to question, how can they have any meaning? Well, do they mean something to a proud program with a dynamic quarterback hoping to make their presence known on a larger stage? Do they mean something to a coach rebuilding a local program torn down by injuries over the last two seasons, trying to give his seniors one last memory? Why do we have so many bowl games? Because for many reasons, and to many people, they do mean something.
And they mean something to these teams, and we can guarantee you that. Maryland from its 35-yard line, down 14-7. Another read option, Brown with a keep. You can always tell whether it's a read option or a straight handoff because the ball stays in a running back's stomach for a long time, and the quarterback's still holding it.
And that's one thing they've gone to more and more in this offense. C.J. Brown, he's a guy, he's not super fast, he's not super quick, he's kind of tall and lanky, but he just has that slippery ability, and he also is a terrific ball handler. So Mike Locksley, the offensive coordinator, going to more and more actual zone reads because Brown is so good at that ball handling.
Brown with good protection, throws wide open. Holy cow, Edetawa was standing out there by himself, and I think he was really concerned about dropping a pass in that situation. The first thing he did was make sure he had it, and he made sure twice.
Well, A.J. Leggett, the safety to that side, lets Edetawa go, but there was a deep route to the far side, and it was because of good protection. Yeah, it was almost like a fair catch. But you've got to catch it first. But a good read by C.J. Brown because the safety on the other side had been run off.
Fly sweep to Jacobs, and Jacobs tripped up on an outstanding tackle by A.J. Leggett. Back on that last catch, it was like, I got it? Yeah, I got it. Okay, now I can run again.
Every receiver will tell you the hardest catch is when you're wide open, the ball's in the air for a while, and you know the defense is closing.
You have time to think about it.
Yeah.
You don't need that.
I'm not sure how much defense we're going to see this afternoon the way these two quarterbacks are playing for, that's for sure.
Read option again. Jacobs, a lot of room to run inside the 10. That was beautifully executed.
And Jacobs, a guy who stepped up. We mentioned the last drive for Maryland with Stephon Diggs and Deion Long, their two best receivers, hurt, both with broken legs, coincidentally, against Wake Forest. Diggs was a guy, we saw Jacobs in that Clemson game go for over 150 yards at a 71-yard touchdown on a really easy throw down the middle where he just outran the middle safety for Clemson. So a guy they're getting more involved in the package.
Reed again, Brown. Inside the 5, down to the 4-yard line. Reed got him a good block.
When guys run this read option well, it's impossible to know who has the ball sometimes. I thought for all the world that that ball was handed off to Ross. And a lot of times you'll go see the defensive end of that side tackle the running back.
Sure.
Because he can't tell. I think probably the same thing, some type of option, maybe with a throw here.
Ross is the deep man in this formation.
Uncovered slot receiver, Maryland's missing.
Brown looked for the pitch. There was nothing there. And then when he turned back inside, there was nothing there either. Darrell Roberts, a corner, number 7, was right up in his grill.
Marshall
turned back up. He got it.
Marshall went and doubled the outside receiver, left the inside receiver completely uncovered. But C.J. Brown, well, the linebacker's over to that side a touch, Stephon Houston, but that extra, because Houston didn't go out and cover, he becomes the extra linebacker to that side. C.J. Brown should have gotten out of that play.
Got Jacobs to the near side, Edetawa to the far side. Now send Ross in motion. 3-4-man rush, and the pass too high for Edetawa, covered by Darrell Roberts.
You think field goal here. But the way Marshall's been playing offensively, I know it's 4th and 7, but I wouldn't be so sure if Maryland wouldn't try a fake or something here. It feels like Marshall may score every time they go out on the field. I know it's early in the ballgame, but
I want to see you get an offensive coordinator job because I know you don't want to punt. Now you don't want field goals. You're going to score a lot of points, or you're not going to score any.
Or I'm going to get fired halfway through the season.
That's it. Craddock with a field goal try, chip shot, 25-yard effort is good. And the Terps cut the lead to 4.
Well, that last throw there by C.J. Brown just missed it. Was going for the fade, but had to settle for 3.
TD Ameritrade, helping you reach your long-term goals one small step at a time.
We're going in with a 4-man team.
We're fixing to get into a pretty good gunfight.
God's looking out for us. We're going home.
Lone Survivor, rated R.
Bringing popcorn to game day is like going for a tie. Nobody wins. Introducing Taco Bell's Variety Taco 12-Pack. 6 Doritos Locos Tacos and 6 Classic Crunchy Tacos. A game day tradition since right now.
Sunday NFL Countdown gets you ready for the NFL postseason.
Big boys are out this weekend.
It's a good football team. Can they go all the way? I don't know.
We're going to judge them based on the postseason.
Sunday NFL Countdown, Sunday at 10 on ESPN.
Tis the season for NBA League Pass with this limited-time holiday offer. You'll get live NBA games on your TV, computer, tablet, and phone. Watch the incredible action anywhere. Buy NBA League Pass for only 4 payments of $42.99. To order now, call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or visit directtv.com/NBA.
On the wing, shoots a two!
How can you make your favorite team your home team?
Oh my.
With NHL Center Ice, you get a season ticket to your favorite team no matter where you live.
Unbelievable!
Plus, you'll get up to 40 other great matchups every week from around the league.
Absolutely off the charts!
So bring home all the action of your team. NHL Center Ice, the game lives where you do. Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS for the lowest price in over 5 years.
Tomorrow, Capital One Bowl Week has you covered all day. A marathon of college football. First at noon, Rutgers, Notre Dame, New Era, Pinstripe Bowl. Then at 3:20, the Belk Bowl, Cincinnati, North Carolina. At 6:45, Miami of Florida battles 18th-ranked Louisville in the Russell Athletic Bowl. Then at 10:15, the Buffalo Wild Wings Bowl, Michigan, Kansas State. Capital One Bowl Week tomorrow, all afternoon and all night on ESPN, as well as live on Watch ESPN. You just joined us, 14-10, Marshall over Maryland. Reeves, this time cut down at the 26-yard line.
0-1, 0-1.
Oh my, come here, come here.
Reeves returns the kick to the 26-yard line.
Rakeem Cato is already set. His name in another page of the Marshall record book with his 79th career touchdown pass. Then he threw number 80. He's along the backfield. Maryland brings 5 men on the rush. Cato hangs in there, throws down the middle, intended for Hoskins. I think he wanted to hold on to that, maybe
did.
One more beat before he threw the deep post.
And one thing, when you study Cato and really watch his mechanics, he's worked really hard. He will fall back some. You know, a moment ago we saw C.J. Brown and that pressure step into it. Cato, because he has played so much where he had to run around and make plays, he has a tendency sometimes to fall back, but he's been working on that.
Looks to his left, throws that same post. Great catch, Devon Smith. Picked it right off of the grass.
This ball with a little zip, not perfectly thrown, but you can see when he gets into it, Cato can. Throws a nice little spiral. Good catch by Smith. You get that ball up just another foot, though, and your receiver keeps running. Who knows how far he goes.
Cato takes off and slides in safely at the 43. Flag down.
wondering if they're getting Cato for signaling first down after getting up
not.
And
I hope not.
Unsportsmanlike conduct. Offense, number 12. 15-yard penalty. First down. That's number 12's first unsportsmanlike.
You know, they have a thing about excessive celebrations in college. There's no gesturing, no taunting. That's ridiculous. You can't call that. Come on. Young man's excited, gets up.
There's a limit to this.
And Doc Holliday, taking a moment, use your head, think. But we can't call that in college football. I understand no gesturing towards an opponent, nothing pre-planned. That was completely spur of the moment, saying first down. That's a terrible call.
So that backs him up to the 40. Cato sidearms this one for Schuler, who wants a flag and gets it.
Well, this is
covered by Matt Robinson, the linebacker. There's a tough matchup for you.
I was just going to say, and Robinson, clearly the best cover linebacker for Maryland, is a former defensive back, but you do not want him on Schuler, a guy who's caught over 200 balls the last 2 years.
Pass interference, defense, number 40. The penalty enforced at the spot of the foul, automatic first down.
And one of the things that Brian Stewart wanted to do was try to bump Schuler when he's lined up to that side. And so that's the reason Robinson's on there. But you don't want that guy having to cover shorter routes. I know you want to bump him, but if anything, run the linebacker through him, bring someone over the top. You don't have to have number 40 turning and running with that guy.
Blitz coming again. They throw to Schuler underneath, who gets what he can. Finally driven out of bounds by Isaac Goins.
And how easy was it for Marshall to get those 15 yards back from that penalty?
Not hard at all.
I mean, my gosh.
Really impressed by Cato. Fires to a wide open Hoskins. And if Maryland is trying to double cover Hoskins or Schuler, they're not doing a very good job of it because they've been open a lot.
There is a lot of confusion. That time Matt Robinson again, who's now walking out again on Devin Smith. He was on Devin Smith and had no help. This is a linebacker. Now he's a former defensive back, but they're just taking advantage of that.
Well, they fit that throw in there somehow to Schuler. Really had to whistle that ball to make it complete. No, even though he's a former defensive back, now he's 240 pounds.
Yeah.
He can't keep up with a wide receiver.
And that time he was over covering Devin Smith, trying to do the same thing they were doing with Schuler and bumping him early. But I don't think that plan is working. I think you want to back off, have secondary guys in there.
Cato again with time. And Schuler stopped that time.
Yeah, that looked like a miscommunication.
Not sure whether he stopped because he thought that was the pattern or he saw the safety.
I think he saw the safety. So here you go, third and goal. Third and seven. Gator Hoskins is in the slot. This is your bigger body guy.
Four-man rush this time. Cato takes off and taken down at the 10-yard line. Good play by Alex Twine. And this will bring the field goal unit on.
And that time Maryland had Gator Hoskins covered very well. That's exactly where Cato was going, and the coverage was much better. Really, for the first time, it looked like Maryland had all the routes cleanly covered on that third and seven.
Really, you can't double cover everybody, but when you're double covering someone, it should look like you're double covering someone. This will be a 27-yard try from Haig. And Marshall regains a 7-point advantage. Military Bowl in Annapolis. It is a 7-point ball game. The Thundering Herd in charge.
In the heart of the most powerful city in the world, Events DC delivers world-class events that connect, delight, and inspire. Our passion shines through, making every event special. Experience all that Events DC can offer. Engage, excite, entertain in a city like no other.
Weather conditions aren't nearly as nice as where we came from. With the wind chill, it's 10 below.
We have have record lows out there, so bundle up.
Now with My Buick Remote Start, the new Buick Enclave makes sure you're ready for anything. Just one more way, the new Enclave is smart, made beautiful. Ring in the new year with 0% financing for 60 months on the 2014 Buick Enclave.
This is the Quicksilver Cashback Card from Capital One. It's not the fumbling around with rotating categories card. It's not the getting blindsided by limits card. It's the no game playing, no earning limit having, geek bomb throwing, give me the ball and I'll take it to the house, Cashback Card. This is the Quicksilver Cash Card from Capital One. Unlimited 1.5% cash back on every purchase, everywhere, every single day. So let me ask you, what's in your wallet?
Mine was earned orbiting the moon in 1971.
Afghanistan in 2009.
On the USS Saratoga in 1982.
Once it's earned, USAA auto insurance is often handed down from generation to generation, because it offers a superior level of protection, and because USAA's commitment to serve current and former military members and their families is without equal. Begin your legacy. Get an auto insurance quote. USAA. We know what it means to serve.
The 2013 Military Bowl is presented by Northrop Grumman. Northrop Grumman, the value of performance. And in part by the new luxuriously innovative LaCrosse from Buick and the Quicksilver card from Capital One. Earn 1.5% cash back on every purchase.
30-40 minutes down Route 50 from Annapolis. It's our nation's capital and all those incredible monuments. Never been, do yourself a favor and go. Both Ed and I have spent a lot of time up here. It's worth it every trip. Likely on the return. Big hole up the middle and caught from behind at the 25-yard line. Likely nearly had a huge return. Stephon Houston, the freshman linebacker, made a saving tackle.
Janine Edwards was talking about the impact Likely had on defense and then starting to do it on special teams as well. Houston, one of the guys that we talked about that Marshall has added with good speed, a true freshman linebacker. If he doesn't close that gap and make the tackle, I think that's a touchdown for Maryland.
Brown will start from his own 25 with 9:21 to go first half. Brown gives it off to Reed, and Albert Reed will pick up 7, maybe 8 yards before Neville Hewitt got him. Those three inside linebackers for Marshall that they rotate are 1, 2, 3 in tackles this year.
And it looked to me at the end of the play like Hewitt landed on the right leg of Reed. And this is an all too familiar sight for Maryland fans. Reed, the second string running back to Brandon Ross, but a really important player as far as work ethic and attitude. He's a guy when during the struggles, Reed stood up in a team meeting, said, I'll stand up, and he's just worked so hard. But unfortunately, an injury that, frankly, I'm shocked we don't see more often when a defensive player is on someone's back. It's why the horse collar tackle has been outlawed. Because a lot of times when you pull a guy down, his legs get caught up with the defender, and it looked like that's what happened there to Albert Reed. And a nice run, too. Good cut. Get yourself to second and short, and unfortunately not able to put weight on that left leg.
No, he sure can't.
And unfortunately for the Terrapins, been there, done that. It's next guy up. Of course, Brandon Ross is the starter. But it is just unbelievable. It's gotten so bad they even lost their long snapper, Greg Parcher. And these guys lost all significant time. Of course, C.J. Brown had the concussion against Florida State and then had a midsection injury to his ribs against Wake Forest. Couldn't finish that ball game. It's been really tough.
It's going to mean extended duty for Ross, number 45. They send Jacobs in motion. Pressure coming on Brown. Airs it out for Edetawa, and he couldn't hold it. Darrell Roberts was there but never saw the ball. Got a little bit lucky, and Edetawa couldn't make the catch.
Roberts, a guy that Marshall did not have in the champion conference USA championship game against Rice, and it really hurt Marshall. But this was step for step coverage. Both guys are hand fighting. You let that go. So good no call, but Edetawa had a chance on that. I like that coverage there. Good news for Marshall to have Roberts back from that left ankle injury he suffered against East Carolina.
And they really missed him in the championship game against Rice. He is their best man-to-man cover guy. Brown tripped up from behind. Excellent effort by Alex Bazzi, the right defensive end, who chased him down. Just got a piece of an ankle.
Bazzi, one of those undersized defensive ends, really built on speed. Just got a toenail. I'm not so sure, or excuse me, a heel. I'm not sure McKelvey, the linebacker, doesn't come and make the tackle, but a good effort by Bazzi. And now Marshall, who has not been stopped really at all, except stopping themselves on offense, getting the ball back.
Smith and Reeves, the dual safety. Late fair catch signal at the 31 by Devon Smith. Kick of 37 yards. Marshall will start from its own 31-yard line, up 7 when we come back to Annapolis, Maryland.
The Valero Alamo Bowl, Monday at 6:45 on ESPN.
Play You Can't Touch This.
You can't touch this.
Play Keep Your Hands to Yourself.
Don't hand me no lines and keep your hands to yourself.
All right, Dad. We get it.
With IntelliLink, all your music is ready to listen to, even if some people are sick of hearing it. The new luxuriously innovative LaCrosse from Buick. During the Buick holiday event, current non-GM owners lease this 2014 Buick LaCrosse with 2 years of Sirius XM for around $299 per month.
Hi, we're the Souls. We're new to town.
Welcome to Monroe.
So you can move more effortlessly.
Wanted to open a new account, checking and savings.
Oh, we can help with that.
We tend to do a lot of banking.
You play?
Yeah.
Discover a mobile app that lets you bank more freely and feel at home more quickly. Chase, so you can.
For an offer that's going to blow you away. Visa.com is the web's most trusted penny auction source, with discounts you have to see to believe. There are hundreds of brand name, brand new products every day, and they're delivered lightning fast right to your door. Laptops, tablets, gift cards, big screen TVs, and way more. All at blowout prices. Visa is happy to offer new users $100 off their first auction win. These are a few items that have recently been won for under $100. And because the price only moves up one penny at a time, you get incredible discounts like 85, 95, even 99% off retail.
Wait a minute. Here's some big news. Get over to Bezit for your shot at $75,000 in amazing prize packages. One winner every week. Join right now.
See the code at the bottom of your screen? Enter it when you join to take advantage of this special offer. That's BEEZID.com. Bezit.
Marshall quarterback Rakeem Cato, the Conference USA Offensive Player of the Year. A season ago, he had 37 touchdown passes, 36 coming into this game, tied for third most nationally, ranks 10th in passing yards in the FBS division. He has had two magnificent years, with one more to come to rewrite the record books in Huntington, West Virginia.
He's going to have a good year, but I think he's going to take over Chad Pennington for most yards.
Cato on the run just throws it away.
Yeah, bad snap there by Jaspers.
Let's go to Janine Edwards.
Well, guys, definitely the MVP on the Marshall sideline, and I'm talking most vocal player, is Rakeem Cato. I've been watching him from the very beginning of the game. I heard a guy screaming when I got over there behind their benches. It was him screaming at his teammates, telling them they were slacking, telling them that they needed to get their act together. He is a fiery, competitive guy who has really turned into a leader this year.
And Janine, that's one thing that they were so pleased about, not only his decision-making, but his leadership.
And the whole time, he's coaching. It's not just talking to guys to talk to them. They're talking about what we're doing, what's the coverage, I need you to do this. Constantly working that relationship with Shula, we mentioned, goes back to grade school.
Third and long. And complete to the Maryland 41, and the defensive backs looking at each other like, didn't you have him? I thought you had him. Wow. Devontae Allen was wide open, makes the catch for 27 yards, and Goins and Davis just ended up staring at each other.
And, you know, Janine reported earlier that Brian Stewart was upset with his guys not knowing what the call is. That's just total confusion there by Isaac Goins and Sean Davis, the safety on that side. Obviously, Goins was playing an underneath corner because there was a route coming to him, and he expects the safety to get over there. I think, if anything, it was just Davis late getting to that side of the field, but there was really nothing to hold him there. And you can see Randy Edsel, who was a defensive coach, having a talk with Davis that you have to get open from that side, and an injury, unfortunately, for Marshall's left tackle, Garrett Scott.
And it's the same spot where Clint Van Horn was hurt. So now they face the possibility of losing both of their starting offensive tackles.
So Gage Niemeyer. You could also. The problem is Garrett Scott listed as the backup. They were doing a three tackle rotation with he, Van Horn, and Gage Niemeyer. So now, with fresh tackles coming out,
now they're going to send number 63 Niemeyer to the right tackle spot.
And then at left tackle, they're going deep into moving people around. They're taking Mendelson and putting him at left tackle, backup guard.
Hold it!
Put a screen out to the right side, and they got it to Frohnapple, and Frohnapple has a first down, but it looks like it'll come back on a holding call.
Yeah, I think they're going to get Jazz King, number 24, to that side. Holding on Alvin Hill, the cornerback, who's stepped up since the loss of Dexter McDougal and limited play late of Jeremiah Johnson.
Holding. Offense. 10-yard penalty.
You don't see too many tight ends split out by 20 yards involved in a screen.
Well, and you really like that what Bill Legg, the offense coordinator, is doing. He told us that they have three tight ends, including Hoskins. Now we see Frohnapple, and we've already seen Devin Johnson. So being those guys really involved, he really likes the depth and the size, athleticism of that position.
Frohnapple's twin brother is the backup quarterback to Cato. Four-man rush, a little bit of pressure. That ball was tipped. Hoskins couldn't get to it. Tipped away by Alex Twine.
Well, there's Twine trying to run underneath Hoskins and doing a good job of getting the tip. Twine, a guy who's missed time himself. Boy, that gets old saying that for Maryland players, doesn't it? With a shoulder injury.
Yes.
But Twine, he read that perfectly. Cato did not see him running underneath of that, and Twine clapped those hands together because he could have been running the other way.
Second down and long. Cato, he will not signal as he gets up this time.
Well, this feels like one of those plays where Marshall loves, they love, absolutely love deep patterns. You have three receivers to the right, but you need, look for some type of vertical route on this side, but then someone at about 20 yards maybe stopping to get beyond the sticks. This is hard to believe, but this offense is a makeable down and distance.
They put Shuler and Hoskins on the same side, so it's impossible to double cover both. Instead, this time they'll throw underneath, complete to Devon Smith.
Now, you're outside of range. Justin Haig, their kicker, right, needs to get to about the 25-yard line. I think, you know, they punted last time on the 41. I think you go for it here. I think that was conservative. You did get the flop of the field, so it worked. But I think this is one where you go for it.
I think inside the 40, it's almost automatic.
Yeah, and then I think for Cato, as he gets the play from that side. Obviously, this is a throw down, but if I'm Maryland, I would leave someone. Cato doesn't run a lot, but when he takes off, he's quick enough to pick up this down and distance. This is the down and distance where a quarterback's draw could be a good changeup call.
Fourth and six. And they looked like there was some confusion on the play or the decision as the punt team was gathered around the coaching staff. So they've called a timeout to talk about it.
I think this is clearly a go for it if you're Marshall. It's a bowl game.
Punting from the 37 to be about as conservative as you'd want. Capital One Bowl Week continues New Year's Day. Two of the nation's most physical teams collide in the granddaddy of them all. Number four, Michigan State, the Big Ten champs, led by quarterback Connor Cook, go after their first Rose Bowl win since 88. But Tyler Gaffney and number five, Stanford, are standing in the way. They're going after two straight Rose Bowl titles. The 100th Rose Bowl game, New Year's Day. Coverage starts at 4:30 Eastern on ESPN. It's part of Capital One Bowl Week.
If you're about to defend Stanford, do you want to suspend your middle linebacker?
Oof.
No, Max Bulla sent home by Mark D'Antonio. And wow, a delay of game called for Marshall to back up and punt. That's too conservative. I think you go for it there on the 37-yard line, fourth and six.
I wonder if they were trying to let the clock, well, I don't know why they let the clock tick down before calling a timeout, but the penalty backs it up at the 43. Another high floater that takes a great bounce for Marshall. That baby was headed for the end zone. And like a lob wedge, hit about the two, came back to the five. A 38-yard perfect putt.
Well, and Marshall actually, they didn't take the timeout, so they'll have three going into the end of the half, but that's the second time that Williams has downed this in. So, well, this one's right on the five. The other one was inside the five, but awfully conservative. I know you're up 7-0, but the way your offense has been playing, you feel like fourth and six, you'll be able to pick it up. And if not, Maryland still has good ways to go with the ball.
C.J. Brown under center. Ross, the tailback, a little short toss. And Ross just back to the line of scrimmage. Remember the last time they were in the situation when they were backed up at the 1 yard line? A couple of plays, they were nearly forced into a safety because Marshall was getting tremendous penetration.
Second down, 10.
And now for Maryland. Game that looked like it was going to go back and forth all of a sudden. Clock ticking at the end of the half, but they're backed up, and you feel like they're C.J. Brown, because he can run though, and it gives you that option when you're backed up. If you get him on the edge, because he can always take off, pick up 6 or 7 yards.
They give it to Ross. Ross gets the first down out to the 18-yard line, and operating room for the Terps with 4:26 to go in the half.
Nice run, good acceleration when he found the soft spot. Watch Ross as he takes it. That sideways handoff. You're reading it the whole way, right there. Excellent cut back underneath, good acceleration. When you watch him on film, he's a good slasher. When he sees it, he takes that nice elongated step to gain some distance between he and the nearest defender.
And Ross is going to have to be the workhorse because Reed is hurt. Brown on the keeper, up to the 30.
And this is where this offense can start to become very dangerous, especially when they start to get their full complement receivers back. As good as they've gotten, as much depth as they have out at their receiver spots, as C.J. Brown comes back next year, the availability of a run pass threat with a guy with another year getting better in the pocket, it's going to be an awfully difficult offense to defend next season.
People should remember that Diggs and Long were on their way to all-star caliber seasons when they got hurt. Little pitch to Ross. Nice decision by Brown. Gary Thompson makes the tackle for Marshall. Clock continues to run. 3:24 and counting, first half. Brown in trouble. Flushed. Directing traffic. Stops. Throws it up for grabs, and it's caught at the 30. Laverne Jacobs. Tyquan Lang got turned around, had trouble finding the ball, and Jacobs found it.
Well, as C.J. Brown breaks out of the pocket, Jacobs goes back because there's two guys there. Wisely, Jacobs goes to get the separation, and here goes Maryland going fast.
Ross to the 20. Usually the rule is whoever's run a short pattern goes long, whoever's run deep comes back, and they did that very, very well.
Absolutely. Good job by Laverne, and here goes Maryland going fast again. Feel like they have Marshall on their heels.
Got Jacobs in the slot to the far side. That's where they're going to throw. Jacobs flanker screen. Room to run, picks up about 8 yards before it's touched by anybody. Driven out of bounds. Had Daniel Adams out there, who was the widest of the wide receivers, blocking for.
Well, you know, you're sitting here at 2:42 to go in the half, both teams with all three timeouts. And yet, I think you have to start thinking, if you're Marshall, not that it's a foregone conclusion that Maryland's going to score seven here, but you may want to start, if you're Marshall, thinking about those timeouts to save him for Rakeem Cato in that offense.
Ross. Driven back as he reached the line of scrimmage. He was drilled by Corey Tindall.
And if I'm Maryland, I'm... We've seen them. We saw them against Clemson huddle, take their time. I'm not so sure I'd be in a huge rush here if I were Maryland. With three timeouts, take your time. Maybe force Marshall to use their timeouts. I know you want to keep the momentum and keep the lather, and there is a rhythm to this offense, but I'd be really happy letting this melt down, which it looks like they are.
First priority is to get that first down. Brown on the keeper, and he can't get it. He'll lose four. What a great play by Alex Bazzi. And this Brown needed to pitch that ball.
Well, I think that Brown got nervous because Bazzi gets in there so quickly. He goes right inside, and he's on Brown. I'm not sure why Brown looked like Brown had that ball cradled. It looked like he should have been able to get it out and flip there. I'm not so sure he handled the ball cleanly, but that's the second time that we've seen Bazzi, and we've seen at least five times where Maryland's offensive line has really struggled with the quick front of Marshall. This is exactly what we heard from Mike Locksley, the offensive coordinator for Randy Edsall, that they were concerned about.
If you're a quarterback, you have to think somebody might be on me instantly. I've got to be able to make that decision, but he looked surprised that Bazzi had that much penetration. And we'll check in with Janine.
Well, guys, you're in good hands when your personal kicking coach is the Baltimore Ravens legend, Matt Stover. The four things that Brad Craddock has learned from Stover: visualize, keep your hips back, your chest open, and keep your head steady. Let's watch.
Well, those tips have worked. He's 20 of 24. So he hit a 25-yarder in this one. And this one's from 33 and good. So somewhere Matt Stover is smiling, as are Terrapin fans. Technique is what counts for kickers.
At Northrop Grumman, we know in the cyber world, threats are always evolving. At first, we were protecting networks. Then, we were protecting the transfer of data. And today, it's evolved to infrastructure. Finance. And military missions. We are constantly innovating to advance the front line in the cyber battle, wherever it takes us. That's the value of performance. Northrop Grumman.
At Farmers, we make you smarter about insurance because what you don't know can hurt you. What if you didn't know that posting your travel plans online may attract burglars?
Off to Hawaii.
What if you didn't know that as the price of gold rises, so should the coverage on your jewelry?
Ah.
What if you didn't know that kitty litter can help you out of a slippery situation? The more you know, the better you can plan for what's ahead. Talk to Farmers and get smarter about your insurance.
We are Farmers. Bum, ba, da, bum, 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 bum.
I, descender of the demon horde. I, my father's son. I, Frankenstein. I am out there, fighting to defend you. This ends tonight.
I, Frankenstein. Rated PG-13. Experience it in IMAX 3D.
Play You Can't Touch This.
You can't touch this.
Play Keep Your Hands to Yourself.
Don't hand me no lines and keep your hands to yourself.
All right, Dad. We get it.
With IntelliLink, all your music is ready to listen to, even if some people are sick of hearing it. The new luxuriously innovative LaCrosse from Buick. During the Buick holiday event, current non-GM owners lease this 2014 Buick LaCrosse with 2 years of Sirius XM for around $299 per month.
I'm Reese Davis. Coming up at halftime, we'll look back at bowl action last night in which a Pittsburgh freshman erased Tony Dorsett from the record book. We'll also look ahead the Texas Bowl, Minnesota's powerful running game, and what Syracuse can do about it. And Duck Dynasty's been canceled. It's not what you think. The change on the Oregon coaching staff, Mark and Lou are here. We'll see you at halftime, guys.
All right, Reese, thanks very much. Yeah, I'll be interested in Duck Dynasty.
The state of Louisiana is actually going to start producing the show. We were just down in New Orleans. That was in the paper the other day.
DeAndre Reeves and Devon Smith are deep for Brad Craddock's kick. Reeves from the four and stopped at the 22-yard line. Marshall will have a minute and 15 seconds to go in the half. This should fit right in their wheelhouse as much as they like to throw the ball downfield.
And a good timeout use by Marshall after that third down stop by Bazzi. They used one of their three timeouts. A minute 15, remember, in college football, not only does the clock stop for incomplete and out of bounds, but also beyond the first down marker, they stop until those markers are moved. So that also slows down the clock. So a minute 15 with two timeouts, plenty of time for Marshall. The thing is, don't let a 30 or 40 second play happen where it takes forever for everyone to get back. If you're in that situation, use one of those timeouts.
Taliaferro is the setback, but they will throw. And the catch made by Shuler.
And because
Shuler and Cato go all the way back to grade school when they used to go to each other's houses, play on youth league teams together. They played together two different high schools, won the Florida State 6A championship. Almost broke up when Shuler agreed to come here, but Cato finally agreed that he would follow, and on the run gets as much as he can out at the 35-yard line.
And this is one of the things that, because Cato is so competitive, because he works so, you talked about Shuler, these guys go out in front of their dorm room and play catch sometimes. That's how close they are. But sometimes he'll try to fit a ball. That time he had Shuler standing over the middle, but he decided to run out of bounds, and I think that was a wise decision. One of the things they're working with Cato, don't try to make every throw. Good decision there.
52 seconds left in the half. Taliaferro breaks it up the middle of the 49. That'll stop the clock at the 46-second mark. Anthony Nixon made the stop after 14 yards.
And what a terrific call. With two timeouts, you can have a couple of runs, and now because of the first down, you only lose about 3 seconds there between plays.
Bill Legg has really done a nice job with this offense.
Here's where you got to think about a timeout if you're Marshall. Watch how long this takes. Yeah, they missed 4 seconds there. Because it was short, and because it's a play where all of your receivers are scattered around the field, you have to get that timeout. You just cost yourself another play. You could have had 35 or 34 seconds here instead of 31. And I think Holiday is trying to get those seconds back. Let's see if Shuler.
Oh, what a great job.
My goodness.
Talk about fingertips. 6 catches for 44 yards for Shuler. That gives him 103 for 1,141 yards for the season.
And I think his right hand was underneath that ball enough. Even upon review, that's going to hold up. But for Doc Holliday, his argument trying to get seconds back on the clock, let's see if those 3 or 4 seconds they missed with that timeout come back to haunt them on this drive.
See that last catch, you can understand why he's caught over 100 balls 2 years in a row. Cato Flush still looking to throw, and he got it to Shuler again. out of bounds at the 33. That's the difference between a quarterback who runs looking to pass and a quarterback who just runs.
And this is a guy who clearly is looking to throw, and he's going to Shuler, his best pal, lifetime best pal. It really does look like they have a good feeling for each other. But you cannot Shuler now lined up in the slot on the top.
Need about 7 or 8 for a first down. This pass, a post, underthrown, intended for Hoskins, thrown into triple coverage. And Robinson, the linebacker who was trailing the play, got a hand on it. He was the closest to it. That was an ill-advised throw. That was no way that was going to be complete.
But remember, Cato loved that matchup on the last drive with the linebacker walked out there, Matt Robinson. That was what Brian Stewart wanted, was to be a little more physical with these little receivers. That time, Robinson did a nice job.
This time, 3 wide receivers left to the wide side. Maryland has 3 defenders over there. Blitz coming. They'll throw back to the near side. And Craig Wilkins was knocked out of bounds. Good defensive play by Isaac Goines.
Goines just absolutely dominated the entire play. Talk about jam coverage. He jammed his receiver over to the sidelines. The receiver quit running, but Cato's got to see that jam and come off of that read. Now with 14 seconds and 3rd and 10, you have to have something beyond the sticks, and if you don't, you better be ready with that timeout. Still not quite in that field goal range.
Goines again, and again, Goines was out of bounds.
I have no idea why you would call the exact same route, the exact same play, unless you're trying to get a pass interference call on Goines, but that time, he took Wilkins, jammed him in the chest completely legally, and drove him out of bounds. The play before, you threw it to air because of Goines on the bottom of your screen. That's just completely legal, good defense. 2 times in a row. Not sure why you'd call the second play to the same spot that didn't work before.
4th and 10 outside of field goal range, and they're out to go for it.
It's got to be something. You have Shuler and Hoskins up here to the top. And I think this is somewhere that you got to look at those guys.
And they've got to use their last timeout because the play clock was at 1.
3rd and final.
So now this is going to change
30 second timeout.
What you can call. If you throw the ball downfield, the clock will stop for a first down if you get that, but only until a ball is spotted. So it's going to be iffy.
Right. So the thing you have to be worried about now is you have to back up and think between 4 and 8 seconds it takes to run an offensive play. So the problem here is, if you get inside of 3 seconds, will you be able to get your field goal unit on to kick the ball, because they had to use that timeout? That was a mismanagement of clock there. If you knew you were going for it on 4th and 10, you're clearly outside of field goal range. You've just got to have that play ready. And now, if you get the first down, I would think Marshall needs to go up and spike it to ensure that they'll be able to bring their field goal unit on. But they may have to go really fast unless they get something near the sidelines and they get out of bounds.
9 seconds on the clock.
And there still seems to be a little confusion between the receivers and Cato.
Cato flushed. This will be the last play unless there's a penalty. He completes it over the middle to Taliaferro, but time has expired.
Boy, mismanagement. Just a complete mismanagement at the end on that 4th and 10. Marshall just losing that last timeout and coming away with no points. All the world looked like Marshall was going to drive down and at least get a field goal try.
Let's go to Janine Edwards.
Coach, I've seen a lot of discussions and coaching going on with your defense in this first half. How are they being challenged the most so far?
Well, we're making some mistakes, and we're just not playing our fundamentals and our technique exactly the way we need to. We just got to get everybody just to do their job, and if we do that, we're okay. When we do that, we're fine. It's just a matter of, guys just taking care of their own business.
And on offense, you had told us that the zone reads and the quarterback run would be important in this game. How effective have you guys been so far?
It's been effective. We got a couple things, same thing. We got a couple pitches that we got to slow down a little bit on and pause a little bit more. But, again, what we're doing is we're shooting ourselves in the foot a little bit offensively where we're not finishing. We got to be able to finish the drive for touchdowns.
Thanks for the time, Randy.
Thank you.
at the half. Our score, Marshall 17, Maryland 13. Now we send you to Reese Davis for our halftime show.
All right, Mike, Marshall trying to get to that 10-win mark. They have the lead, entertaining first half. The Hall of Famers alongside Lou Holtz and Mark May back from their Hawaiian vacation.
Yeah.
Perhaps a little later on, Lou will explain why it's not a good idea to reveal your hotel number on national television. But there have been some numbers unveiled on national TV that are okay. Rakeem Cato going over 10,000 yards passing for his career and showing to be a very dangerous quarterback.
He definitely is. Coming into the game, he had 36 touchdown passes. In this game, he's 17 of 26 for 193. But what he does is he keeps the play alive with his feet. He's got excellent feet in the pocket. Not much of a runner, but he can get it done. But he throws the ball with great accuracy. In the pocket or on the move, he can get it done. Has two more touchdown passes in this game. Has some great wide receivers that go after the football. But I like his confidence in the huddle. The junior's done a terrific job throughout his career of putting points on the board and getting the ball to his wide receivers.
You have to really be impressed with Maryland. You consider the amount of injuries they've had this year at the wide receivers, at offensive line, and yet they find a way to be very competitive. Here they are in a bowl, and they're only down 17-13. You have to give them an awful lot of credit.
You know, the thing about Maryland's injuries over the last couple of years is not things where you would look at and say, well, maybe they train differently. These are like catastrophic, bizarre injuries. Well, I'm not laughing about the injuries. Hey, it's odd.
They lost two of the best receivers in the country for the year. I mean, they would really be good.
Yeah, no question about it. So the future looking bright for Maryland. Last night, Poinsettia Bowl, the Heisman Trophy finalist Jordan Lynch, Northern Illinois, taking on the Aggies of Utah State. Huskies were down 6-0 in the second quarter. Aggies have a good defense. Did a good job on Fresno State in the Mountain West Championship game, but Lynch caps off a drive with a one-yard run. Then we had 39 yards rushing in the game. And here Lynch had some uncharacteristic turnovers, Mark.
And that's not him to throw interceptions like this. He makes smart decisions with the football. He doesn't make mistakes like this. That's why he's had such an impressive career.
Well, you saw it happen in the MAC Championship game as well against Bowling Green. Darryl Garrettson finding Brandon Swindle for the touchdown. Aggies cash in off the turnover, and they have the lead. And Garrettson, this was a big turning point, Coach, the tipped interception.
Oh, it really was. And I was surprised Utah State played this well because they lost a great quarterback after the sixth game of the year. And then to have Garrettson come in and play so well.
This was why it was such a turning point, because they got nothing, had a chance to take the lead, missed the field goal. Matthew Sims had really been struggling down the gut of the season. Joey DiMartino at 143 yards. And the Aggies get the victory 21-14 in the Poinsettia Bowl. Pittsburgh taking on Bowling Green in the Little Caesars Pizza Bowl. Pittsburgh up 10-3. And Tyler Boyd is a freshman that is going to make some serious noise. He's in that Larry Fitzgerald, Antonio Bryant lineage at wide receiver and punt return.
Does a fabulous job here on the punt return. Stays tight ropes down the sidelines, but he's been super impressive the entire season long as a true freshman for the Panthers.
Pitt bowl record, 173 yards receiving in addition to that 54-yard punt return for a touchdown. Matt Johnson, who was so good in the MAC championship game. Ryan Berberink tied it at 27. But, Lou, what about James Conner, the freshman?
Well, here's a young man, rushed for 229 yards at one time. He's averaging almost 10 yards a carry midway through the third period. But I tell you, the key play was Boyd's reception of 50 yards to set up the winning score.
That run by Conner would set up the winning field goal. Look at Conner playing defense, helping Aaron Donald with a sack. Conner was initially recruited to Pitt to be a defensive player. Those 229 yards, Mark, as you look at notable bowl performances, broke Tony Dorsett's Pittsburgh Bowl record.
The Hawk, and that's mighty impressive. But, Paul, Chris, how come you're not playing James Conner earlier in the season? That's what I asked you. But the freshman was phenomenal. Most impressive performances, both of them for me, by Pittsburgh Panthers. James Conner, the 229, big fella, 230 pounds, a freshman. Tyler Boyd, the wide receiver, 173 yards receiving, a freshman in a punt return for a touchdown.
Against Bowling Green, who lost their coach. But let's go on here to Marquise Lee, the USC wide receiver. Going into the year, he might be the most talented receiver in the entire country. 118 yards and two touchdowns, seven receptions. He's really an outstanding athlete. Good to see him finish so strong.
You know, those two touchdowns doubled his season output. That was remarkable. He had 25 over his first couple of seasons, and this guy was great at keeping opposing players in the Pac-12 out of the end zone. Nick Aliotti, the defensive coordinator for the Ducks, retiring after 24 years of coaching. It was broken up with some time with the Rams and a year at UCLA, but he had been under three different head coaches at Oregon, defensive coordinator since 99. He spanned the gap between Rich Brooks to Chip Kelly, Maya Bilotti, and then finally with Mark Helfrich. You see the great work that Nick has done in his career, one of our favorite guys to cover him. Certainly we wish him well in retirement.
Nothing but the best for Nick Gallagher. He's done a tremendous job for college football, the 24 years in college football, 17 as a defensive coordinator, put a lot of guys into the NFL, and he's been great for Oregon in college football. Nothing but the best, Coach.
What's really amazing, all you think about the Duck Dynasty is offense. And this guy, he's been there for years. Remember, we did a championship game. He did a tremendous job against Cam Newton and Auburn, although they didn't win.
You know, I think perhaps, and I say this somewhat tongue-in-cheek, Nick's most valuable contribution to college football, he has added to our college football final lexicon, country fumble and city fumble. City fumble, a lot of people around it jump on it. Country fumble, pick it up and scoop and score because you're out in the country. Courtesy of Nick Aliotti from Oregon. Oregon will finish its season in the Valero Alamo Bowl against Texas. Speaking of the state of Texas, we will preview the Texas Bowl coming up and also the Fight Hunger Bowl, a couple of games coming up. As your bowl season hits full force on this Friday.
My grandfather was in the Army for over 20 years. Westmoreland was something I always wanted to do. The values that you get, it's gonna stick with you the rest of your life. It makes something like NFL training camp easier because you can deal with it. You've learned to deal with the rigors of the academy.
You're going up against the biggest, fastest, strongest athletes in the world. So physically, it's gonna be tough, yeah. You know? But mentally, I think we had the biggest advantage.
Yeah, I think the military taught us all mental toughness. You know, with us, I believe, you know, just pay your head to the grindstone, staying tried, staying course. That's all we can do.
And, you know, that comes from that discipline. They know you're gonna be disciplined. They know you're gonna do the right thing. So I think that helps in terms of building trust within the organization.
People always ask me, would you do it again? I bet they ask you that too.
It's the toughest, quite hard question.
Yeah. And you look back, you're like, absolutely, you know, I've seen a lot, I've done a lot, and I've met a lot of great people.
Right, and if it was easy, it wouldn't be worth it.
Exactly. You
know? If it was easy, not, yeah. Everybody would do
and
it.
Everyone would do it.
We took the road less traveled, especially to where we are now, to be NFL athletes.
Yeah, it's been a long, challenging journey, but you wouldn't trade that experience for the world. Yeah. I mean, you wouldn't give any of that up.
If you've got your crew in Miller Lite, you've got Miller time.
Fellas, finally, you made it.
But what if one of your crew is Questlove?
Then we brought more Miller Lite.
Cool. What do you got, Swinny, here?
What do you got?
Are you kidding me?
Round to Miller Lite from the ladies in the corner.
Hey, boys.
You guys want to hit this house party? It's in Thailand.
Yes.
It's not just a good time. It's Miller time.
Get new game content first on Xbox.
What to watch for tonight on ESPN, Syracuse and Minnesota. Texas Bowl at Houston's Reliant Stadium. These two teams played September the 2012 season, so not totally unfamiliar with each other. Minnesota's won three straight meetings. And this Minnesota team in the top 15 in the country, Mark, in terms of rushing attempts, they're not trying to fool you. They want to run it at you.
They've got four players that have rushed for 350 yards or more, but they're led by David Cobb. Wasn't even on the depth chart at the beginning of the season. Has over 1,100 yards rushing on the season. Not only that, when he rushes for 80 yards or more, they're 6-1. 80 yards or less, than 80 yards, they're 2-3. Give him the football. He's got to have at least 80 yards for Minnesota to have success if they want to win this football game.
Yeah, but on the other hand, I think that there's a strength. Syracuse football team, it has to be their defense. They're very mediocre on offense, but their defense makes all kind of plays. You look at Darrell Eskridge, you know, he had 78 tackles, four tackles for loss. They just get after you. They play very, very physical, and they're outstanding on third down defense. The big thing, as you said, Mark, they've got to be able to stop the run.
Syracuse may have to find a way to overcome the injuries to Darrell Eskridge and a couple of starters in the secondary who have been injured. BYU and Washington play tonight in the Fight Hunger Bowl. Huskies interim coach Marcus Tuiasosopo before Chris Peterson takes over. Steve Sarkisian, of course, the BYU alum, has moved on to take on at USC. But what Washington leaves behind is they turn the page into a new era. They got one of the best running backs in the country.
End of this segment, I'm on a running back theme. This time it's Bishop Sankey, third in the nation, 1,775 yards. Not only that, he's had seven games over 150 yards. He's the straw that stirs the drink for this offense, gets it done inside and outside. Only 5'10", 203 pounds, but he is physical at the point of attack and quick feet through the hole, knows how to read his blockers, Coach.
But I like BYU defense. They have the most underrated player that you would see, but you talk about their quarterback, Taysom Hall. He's versatile, he can run the ball, he throws the ball, he makes plays. All the secrets of success for BYU is how effective is he. When he's very good, he's outstanding.
Taysom Hill joining Jordan Lynch in the 2,000-yard passing, 1,000-yard rushing club among quarterbacks and accounted for 28 scores. Ought to be a good one, BYU and Washington, a couple of programs familiar with each other. We're at halftime. Military Bowl, Marshall and Maryland. Rakeem Cato's gone over 10,000 yards for his career. Thundering Herd going for 10 wins, up by 4 on the Terps.
And so you can see, you're like right here, I can just, you know, check my policy here, add a car, speak to customer service, check on a claim, you know, all with the tap of my Geico app.
Oh, that's so cool.
Well, I would disagree with you, but that would make me a liar.
No, dude, you're on the Jumbotron.
Yeah, I pretty much walked into that one.
Geico, anywhere, anytime. Just a tap away on the Geico app.
For a limited time, get the Samsung Galaxy S4 for only $49.99 with 2-year activation, only at Best Buy.
For more than 60 years, Wrangler's been making jeans more comfortable. They feel good and wear strong. To me, Wrangler jeans are the most comfortable jeans you'll ever wear. And that's guaranteed.
Wrangler 5-star premium denim jeans are built with a U-shaped construction. They don't cut into you like jeans with a V pattern.
No matter what you're doing or where you're going, nothing beats Wrangler comfort. Wrangler, real comfortable jeans, guaranteed.
Think of the NCAA as a marching band. We wouldn't stop with halftime. We'd be full-time, celebrating student athletes in everything they do. Okay, so don't think of us as a marching band. Think of us as a spirit squad. Well, just know we're always there for student athletes.
In celebration of the 100th Rose Bowl game, a memory.
The 1963 Rose Bowl seemed like a blowout as number one USC led number two Wisconsin 42-14 early in the fourth quarter. Then, Badgers quarterback Ron Vanderkellen caught fire and Wisconsin scored 23 unanswered points. But the furious rally wasn't quite enough as the Trojans held on for a 42-37 victory.
The 100th Rose Bowl game, New Year's Day on ESPN.
I'm here to tell you that 100th Rose Bowl game will not have as many points as they did in 1963. not with Stanford and Michigan State going at it, although the Spartans will be without Max Bulla, their leader on defense.
Oh, you look at both of these teams, everyone talks about how good their defenses are. How about the quarterbacks? Connor Cook for Michigan State, 20 touchdown passes. Kevin Hogan, Stanford, 20 touchdown passes. They've both had decent seasons.
I think it's Stanford's got to turn Kevin Hogan loose. Let him run, let him throw, play it wide open air. Not going to beat Michigan State one-dimensional, although without Mr. Bullock, it might have changed my thought.
Their defense will still be good, but the leading linebacker for Michigan State suspended for the Rose Bowl. The Spartans make their first appearance there since 87. NFL and NBA news coming up after the break.
Your mama's got nothing on me. Your daddy's got nothing on me.
Why would you ever need to eat nachos on the go? Let's say her parents came home early. That's one reason. The new grilled stuffed nacho for $1.29 at Taco Bell. Everything you love about nachos grilled up in an all-new way. Take the nachos and run. Helping you reach your long-term goals, one small step at a time.
I'm a totally different man.
You could do one thing only. Incline training is it.
It eliminated that fat.
Just get up and walk.
You want to change your life, then you need to step up to the X9 from Nordic Track. What makes the X9 the best calorie-burning machine on the planet? Incline. Going up, now you're burning twice the calories. You want more? Take it all the way to 40% incline for 5 times the calorie burn.
The X9 is one of the fastest ways ever to burn calories.
And all you have to do is walk.
Plus, the X9 comes with iFit, powered by Google Maps, so you can work out anywhere.
Burn fat jogging on the beaches of Fiji. Shed pounds hiking the Swiss Alps.
With iFit, the X9 automatically adjusts, so your workout follows the terrain.
You can most definitely shed calories and burn fat.
You can just walk the calories off.
Get this amazing machine for zero down and free shipping, $150 value.
To order, call 1-800-310-0501 or go online today.
Cowboys face a win and you're in, lose and go home game against the Eagles this weekend. They'll have to try to win it without Tony Romo. Out for the season after back surgery today, Kyle Orton will get the start Sunday against Chip Kelly's team. Some other headlines: Adrian Peterson doubtful Sunday against the Lions with a groin injury. Case Keenum's going to be a game-time decision for the Texans at quarterback. And this just breaking, too. Russell Westbrook underwent right knee surgery today. He's expected to be out for the Oklahoma City Thunder until after the All-Star break. You can never miss any news like that with the new SportsCenter app. Blazing fast scores, news, highlights, alerts, access to all your favorite anchors via Twitter. You can follow at ESPN Dr. Lou and get some wisdom. Download the new SportsCenter app by calling *SC from your phone. Second half's coming.
Position to look at the other worlds of our solar system.
Our values call upon us to care about the lives of people we will never meet.
We realize the importance of light when we see darkness.
When you finally get to that point of acceptance, there's nothing more beautiful.
Say my
What kind of energy is so abundant it can help provide the power for all this? Natural gas. More than ever before, America's electricity is generated by it. ExxonMobil uses advanced visualization and drilling technologies to produce natural gas, powering our lives while reducing emissions by up to 60%. Energy lives here.
This is Capital One Bowl Week.
I know you.
Welcome back to the Military Bowl, presented by Northrop Grumman. It is 17-13, Marshall over Maryland at the half. I don't know about you, Ed, but I sort of get the feeling that if Maryland's offense doesn't score a lot more points, they're in trouble because they can't seem to stop Marshall.
Unbelievable. Marshall only has 17 points. It feels like they should have 24 or 31. Of course, remember early on, Cato missed a couple of early throws, but for me, it's back on C.J. Brown. This is where Maryland's season has sat all year. During that three-game skid, he was mostly hurt. He comes back against Virginia Tech and plays well. The read option, and then I think they have to get some read option pass off of that. Edetamba, they also need to get Jacobs down the field. I think there's some guys that they can stretch the field with, but I think it's all through C.J. Brown on this drive, because if they don't get a score here, they're only down three, but I get the feeling Marshall's not going to slow down on offense.
Maryland won the toss and deferred to the second half, so they'll get the ball first. Check in with Janine Edwards.
Well, guys, Marshall coach Doc Holliday knows better than to relax a little bit for this second half. He says the Terps are grinders. We've learned a lot about how salty that team is with all the injuries they've overcome this year. So he said, despite the fact that his team is moving the ball really, really well, he said we better start doing a better job tackling, and we've got to clean up the penalties.
All right, Janine, thanks very much. This is likely on the return, and the freshman forced out of bounds near the 30-yard line. It's been a good day for both quarterbacks. Cato has thrown for 193 yards, two touchdowns. Brown has run well and completed only six of only eight passes that he threw for 128 yards. So he has been very efficient. Corner 35. Stiff arms his way for about 4 yards.
These modern offenses, with how much misdirection, ball handling, throwing, it's so much fun to watch and so hard to defend. That play had about three different directions built into it, and before you knew Ross had the ball, he already had the edge.
It's fun unless you're a defensive coordinator. Play action fake to Ross this time, and Brown takes off. C.J. Brown across the 40.
Brown is one of those guys who is sneaky. He doesn't look like he's running that fast. He doesn't look like he's, there's nothing demonstrative to the moves he makes in the open field to make people miss. Yet he makes people miss, and he picks up great yardage every time he takes off. He's a very smooth runner, long strides, but he gets to the angle. The angle breaks down on defenses, I think, quicker than they think when you watch him on tape.
And he has the top two rushing totals for any quarterback that ever played. Laverne Jacobs, what a catch. Now Maryland's going to hurry to the line of scrimmage. Was this complete?
Oh,
now the point of the ball hit the ground.
And you, the ball can hit the ground on a catch, but what they're looking for, I'd be really surprised if they don't stop this. Yeah, but what they're looking for is, did the ground help make the catch? And I think, in fact, it did there. So I think this will be.
Ruling on the field was a completed catch. The previous play is now under further review.
And I think you'll see the ball move significantly against his body after the point hit the ground.
Yeah, that's the point.
Watch, effort,
yeah, watch the ball. The frame after it hits the ground, it's okay. It's on the ground. Now watch the next frame as we move through the video. Watch the ball. Well, that didn't move as much as I thought. And Jacobs actually did a pretty good job of getting. You could see the white gloves underneath of it. Let's see if we get a better look at it here. You know, that those left fingers, you know, we
you
go
know,
back.
I'm with you. I'm starting to change my mind, too.
It's the left fingers of that ball, and it's this frame here. That frame right there, the ball doesn't move much.
It was called a catch.
I think this is another 50-50 where no matter which way they go, it's tough to argue with it.
I think part of the ball does touch the ground. I think that Jacobs has his left fingers under the ball. And again, this is supposed to be indisputable video evidence. In my opinion, after three watches, I think this is a catch. And we bring in Verl Sorgan, who's a Mountain West Conference observer. And Verl, what do you see here? And what do you think they're looking for?
Well, they're looking, just as you guys have both said, they're looking for what I call independent ball movement, aside from the holding by the receiver. It's iffy. And if it's iffy, then does that qualify as video evidence?
The ruling is an incompleted forward pass.
He said
it'll
yes.
It'll be second down and 10 at the 41-yard line.
Well, Verl, thank you, but that's the second time I've disagreed. I didn't think they should have overturned the touchdown earlier for Marshall, and I didn't think that they should have overturned that catch. Just too close to say it's completely indisputable.
Yeah.
So now, instead of first and 10 over midfield, you've got second and 10 for Maryland back at their own 41, so that's a pretty big penalty. Or excuse me, a pretty big overturn of the reception.
Back to the pistol formation, Ross the deep man. And Ross will get the carry. Pushing the pile forward to the 47-yard line. That'll bring up about third and four.
Maryland has not been great on third down this season. A lot of third and long. They've had their struggles offensively. We mentioned all of the players that have been out for Randy Edsall. But this is where C.J. Brown, his athleticism is so dangerous as a quarterback, because he can run it. He obviously has improved as a passer. It's tough to defend this down the distance.
They were poor season average, and today they've even been worse than average. Brown steps up, throws on the run right through the hands of Edetala.
That was a good throw by Brown. Would have been plenty for the first down.
We've mentioned a bunch in the first half, Stephon Diggs and Deion Long, the two best receivers for Maryland, out since midseason Wake Forest game. Nice job by Brown stepping up, buying some time in the pocket. And Edetala, one of the guys who's been stepping up nicely with Diggs and Long out, just misses it.
So they'll have to kick it away. Devon Smith, number 11, and DeAndre Reeves, the twin safeties. And they'll start inside their 15-yard line. 40-yard kick, no return. Marshall nursing a slim lead, third quarter of the Military Bowl.
At Northrop Grumman, we've always been on the forefront of innovation. When the world called for speed, when the world called for stealth, intelligence, endurance, affordability, adaptability, and when the world asked for the future, staying ahead in a constantly evolving world, that's the value of performance. Northrop Grumman.
This is the Quicksilver Cashback Card from Capital One. It's not the limit the cash I earn every month card. It's not the I only earn decent rewards at the gas station card.
It's the no games, no signing up, everyday rewarding, kung fu fighting, silver lightning in a bottle, bringing home the bacon
cashback card. This is the Quicksilver Card from Capital One. Unlimited 1.5% cash back on every purchase, everywhere, every single day. So ask yourself, what's in your wallet?
At Farmers, we make you smarter about insurance, because what you don't know can hurt you. What if you didn't know that posting your travel plans online may attract burglars?
Off to Hawaii.
What if you didn't know that as the price of gold rises, so should the coverage on your jewelry?
Ah.
What if you didn't know that kitty litter can help you out of a slippery situation? The more you know, the better you can plan for what's ahead. Talk to Farmers and get smarter about your insurance.
We are Farmers. Bum, ba, dum, bum, 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 bum.
Whether you follow one college team or all of them, it's never been easier to get the content you want in one place. NCAA.com cuts through the clutter so you're in control. School Pages connect you with your favorite team so you can access highlights and features you won't find anywhere else. And NCAA.com is championship central with unparalleled access. across all divisions.
Let's go.
Whether at home or on the go, NCAA.com is the home of college sports.
A.J. McCarron looks to roll the tide to one final victory as they take on Bob Stoops Sooners in the Big Easy. The All-State Sugar Bowl, Oklahoma, Alabama. Coverage begins Thursday at 8 on ESPN.
Visit WatchESPN.com or download the Watch ESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
Welcome back to the Military Bowl in Annapolis. Getting a little chilly because the sun has gone down behind the rim of the stadium. And Marshall takes over at its 13-yard line. Taliaferro, who's had some room to run in this ball game, takes it up to the 20. They need to get to the 23 for a first down. 8 carries, 45 yards.
Marshall without Kevin Grooms, usually their best running back, battled some injuries early in the year, now suspended.
Kill go on the stop here as Taliaferro carries again. He came in with 1,059 yards out of Ashburn, Virginia, the home of the Redskins, about an hour and 10 minutes away from here.
Yeah, a nice game against Virginia Tech, his home state school. He went for over 100 yards in that near win, triple overtime loss at Virginia Tech for Marshall.
Taliaferro again to the 33-yard line, and they're going to mark him about a yard shy.
And he's going to have to come out because his helmet came off. Stuart Butler coming in. Well, and it was the arm over the face mask by L.A. Gorey, who, when he spun over, the helmet came off.
They'll throw on second down and throw for a first down. Devon Smith comes up with the grab, his third.
Going back to that Gorey tackle, that's not a face mask. You're allowed to wrap up the helmet as long as you don't grab that face mask and pull it, so not a penalty. Cato looked on rhythm on that throw, didn't he? Just set his feet
good. Victim. Little pump fake here, and Smith had a knee on the ground when he made that catch.
Maryland player with a shoe off. It's Quentin Jefferson, defensive end. Not much pressure we've seen from Maryland.
Straight up the middle goes Stuart Butler, came into this ball game tied for number one in the country with 8.9 yards a carry, has seen very little action. Now third and one. And Taliaferro is back in there. Seems like Marshall has spent most of the day in Maryland territory, and Taliaferro, if they give him forward progress, he's still going to be about a yard shy. And time for another decision by Doc Holliday.
Well, you're over the 50-yard line here. You have to go for it. He's been very conservative on the 41 on about fourth and seven in the first half, decided to punt. Then he took a delay of game with 37 on the 37-yard line. And now I cannot believe he's sending out his punter. This, to me, in a bowl game with less than, looks like about 8 inches to go, you're punting the ball. With Cato at quarterback, Taliaferro's been able to run, get 3-4 yards a pop. This is awfully conservative.
He would say, I know, but I want to win this game, and pinning him back at the 1-yard line is my best shot. And they pinned him deep twice. This will be the third time if they can stop it. But it'll be a touchback, and Williams did his job again. He thought he had three in a row. 44-yard kick, but the Nets only 24. Maryland will start from its own 20-yard line.
At Northrop Grumman, we know in the cyber world, threats are always evolving. At first, we were protecting networks. Then, we were protecting the transfer of data. And today, it's evolved to infrastructure. Finance. and military missions. We are constantly innovating to advance the front line in the cyber battle, wherever it takes us. That's the value of performance. Northrop Grumman.
Belk's After Christmas Sale and Clearance is going on now. It's our biggest denim event of the year, with great prices on your favorite brands. Save on Red Dot Clearance. Take an extra 15% off regular and sale purchases with your Belk card. Or get your shopping pass at Belk.com. Plus, save on doorbusters. 60% off sweaters for the family. 70% off Belk Silverworks jewelry. 75% off Christmas ornaments, decor, and trees. Shop Belk's After Christmas Sale and Clearance. Modern, Southern, style. Belk.
At Ashley, we know a bedroom is a place where ghost stories unfold. A dining room has to work as an office. And a sofa becomes front row seats for the movie. At Ashley's New Year's event, save up to 20%. Find mattress brands you love and save up to $300 on select Tempur Contour Collection mattresses. Plus, special financing available. Out with the old, in with the new at Ashley Furniture Home Store.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
You're not a hunter, are you?
Not anymore.
Eternity can be a curse.
I can make you mortal.
I'm not healing like before.
You have courage, but that won't help much now.
The Wolverine. Movie start at Channel 125.
Get close to all the action wherever you are with the new SportsCenter app. Blazing fast scores, the hottest news, highlights, analysis, as well as access to your favorite SportsCenter talent 24/7 via Twitter. You can download the new SportsCenter app by calling *SC from your phone. Maryland takes over at its own 20, down by 4.
Knock it back! Knock it back!
And they'll get a couple up the middle.
Well, during that break, Rakeem Cato, we've been talking about how competitive he is. And I promise you there had to be a conversation of not going for it on fourth and less than a foot. I mean, it was 6 inches to go from the 44-yard line. Doc Holliday punts for the third time on fourth down this game on the plus side of the field and only nets 24 yards because of the touchback. That's an awfully conservative call on the ball game last game.
Ross stacked up. It's going to be third and 6. Front line of that Marshall defense getting a little tougher here in the third quarter.
Well, this is a defense that made the most drastic improvement for Marshall in the entire country statistically from last year to this year. Brought in a new defensive coordinator in Chuck Heater. There's Chuck. Spent a long time at University of Florida, University of Washington. Spent a bunch of places as defensive coordinator. A really good hire for Doc Holliday, and the improvement in personnel and coaching has been great this year.
When you lower your defensive scoring areas by almost 20 points a game, it's a good thing. Brown tackled by Rouse. James Rouse with penetration again. The MVP voted by his teammates, one of the captains, first team all-conference, and a big-time player.
Well, we've been talking about how C.J. Brown has been given a sixth year. So has this young man, and he announced at the team banquet that he would be coming back, and he just absolutely ran by Sal Conaboy, the center, just straight one-on-one blocking, and Rouse, the senior, coming back for another senior year for Marshall next year. They'll be glad to have him.
Renfro with the punt, and that's going to be a flag as they ran into Smith, Sean Davis.
Free service, and you can trust them to help you.
If you're struggling to find reliable senior living information for your mom or dad, then call or go online to get the free help you need during this turbulent time. Call now, 800-798-7204, 800-798-7204.
I'm Dari Noka. Thank you for watching this Encore presentation on ESPNU. Due to time constraints, we move ahead in our action.
Nice balanced attack here by...